The Tiger, the Brahman, and the Jackal. Once upon a time, a tiger was caught in a cage. He tried to escape, but he couldn't. It happened that a Brahman came by.
"Let me out, please!" cried the tiger.
"Oh, no, my friend," replied the Brahman calmly. "You would probably eat me if I did."
"Not at all," promised the tiger. "If you release me, I'll be your servant for life."
The Brahmin's heart softened and agreed to open the door of the cage. Out popped the tiger.
"You're a fool! Now I am going to eat you!"
The Brahmin begged for his life. The tiger agreed to ask the first three things they met for their opinion on the matter. First, the Brahmin asked a tree,
"What have you to complain about?
Don't I give shade and shelter to everyone who passes by? And don't they, in return, tear down my branches to feed their cattle? The tiger should eat you." Then the Brahmin saw a buffalo, and he asked the buffalo his opinion on the matter.
"You are a fool to expect me to help you. Look at me. Humans only treat me well when I produce milk. Eat him, tiger."
The Brahmin then asked the roe.
"My dear sir," said the roe, "how foolish you are. Here I am, useful to everybody, yet all rich and poor trample on me as they go past, giving me nothing in return."
Just then, he met a jackal.
"Why, what's the matter, Mr. Brahmin? You look as miserable as a dog without a bone."
The Brahmin told him what had happened.
"How very confusing," said the jackal. "Would you mind telling me again, for I am very confused?"
The Brahmin told it all over again, but the jackal still could not understand.
"It's very odd," he said.
"It all seems to go in one ear and out the other. I will go to the place where it happened, and perhaps I shall then understand."
So they returned to the cage, where the tiger was waiting for the Brahmin and sharpening his teeth and claws.
"Now I'm ready to eat you for dinner."
"Please," the Brahmin pleaded. "Let's hear what the jackal has to say." The tiger consented, and the Brahmin began the whole story over again.
"Oh, my poor brain," cried the jackal, wringing its paws. "Let me see. How did it all begin? You were in the cage, and the tiger came walking by."
"Silly," interrupted the tiger. "I was in the cage."
"Oh, of course," cried the jackal. "The tiger was in the Brahmin, and the cage came walking by. No, that's not it either. Well, don't mind me. I shall never understand."
"Yes, you shall," returned the tiger, in a rage at the jackal's stupidity. "I'll make you understand. Look here, I am the tiger."
"Yes, I got that part."
"And that is the Brahmin."
"Okay, then."
"And that is the cage."
"Right."
"And I was in the cage. Do you understand me now?"
"Yes."
"Well," cried the tiger impatiently,
"please, how did you get in it?"
"Why, in the usual way, of course."
"Oh, dear me, but what is the usual way?"
At this time, the tiger lost his patience and, jumping into the cage, cried,
"This way! Now do you understand how it was?"
"Perfectly,"
grinned the sly jackal, as he quickly shut the door.
"And if you will permit me to say so, I think that's where you will stay."